And the PPP has also been speaking, that is a Papa Kwesi Indom's political party, and they have said that the selective style of the IEA is not prudent and would not help the democracy of the country. Their representative has joined us on the line, Paco Akon. He's the director of communications for the PPP. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.
All right, to start with, your flag bearer, that is Dr. Papa Kwesi Indom, has also commented on the IEA's decision to first of all even hold a presidential debate, and the fact that they are sticking with last 4 years' decision to take only presidential candidates who have representation in parliament. This time around, though, they are saying that they are considering the other parties who have flag bearers but do not have representation in parliament. Why do you not see this as fair game?
Well, thank you for this opportunity. First of all, let me say that what the IEA is doing is an attempt to encourage segregation in this country. We all know the effect of apartheid in South Africa and how people lost their lives as a result of the fact that they considered certain actions as unfair. You can't have a political party act which defines what a party is. And we know that the act says that for you to be seen or for you to be considered as a political party, you must have offices in 2/3 of the district of this country. You must be national in character. What the IEA is doing is that political parties are tempted to focus their resources in certain constituencies. So you have a party deciding that, well, we want to focus all our resources in one constituency so that we become recognized. There is nothing like parties with representation in parliament. We practice a multi-party democracy. The objective of the IEA is to strengthen democracy. How do you strengthen democracy when your objective is to segregate, is to set some people apart, is to demonstrate to other people that some people are more important than the others?
Paco, if you listened to what the IEA said the day they announced the proposal of the presidential debate, they mentioned that they are also considering a separate debate or a debate for all presidential candidates who do not have representation in parliament.
That
is also giving the same opportunity to the team.
No, on the day of election, there will be nothing like parties with representation in parliament or presidential candidates who have MPs or presidential candidates who are forerunners. There will be nothing like that. What the IEA is doing is misleading, trying to create the impression that there are only two main parties here. What is the intention of the IEA to do this? What we are saying is that if you want to organize a debate for all parties as qualified per the Political Parties Act, the IEA should not overthrow the constitution of this country. The IEA should not set any new rules in this country. We are a multi-party democracy. If you want us to know how the policies and programs of presidential candidates, put all of them on the same floor and let the people be the best judges. IEA is not God to determine or to foresee who is likely to win. So how would the IEA react?
So did you have
after the 2016 election?
Paco, 4 years ago, the PPP was in existence by then. It was a full-fledged political party. Did you have the same sentiments back then when they held a debate for the presidential candidates with representation in parliament?
You mean 2012 election?
Yes.
Yes, 2012 election, we raised the same issues. And that is why the GBC eventually created a platform for the other presidential candidates. We raised issues, we raised questions with the criteria set by the IEA. It is against our democracy, and we want you, the media, to speak against it. It is never done anywhere, even in the UK, where they also practice multi-party democracy. The Liberal Democrats, the Labour Party, the Conservatives, the SNP, and the other parties are given equal opportunity. Where is the IEA coming from? What do they want to impose on us? That is why I'm saying that apartheid cannot be allowed and should not be allowed in this country. IEA is seeking to promote apartheid here, and we must resist it with all our might.
All right. Thank you very much, Paco Akon.